Hello everyone, this is Satish here. I hope you guys are doing wonderful. So I'm sharing this video to you today so to discuss about the very one of the very important Raja Yoga in Vedic astrology, that's Sun plus Ketu conjunction in Vedic birth chart. That's called Kirti Yoga as well. Ketu conjunction in Vedic birth chart is considered as Kirti Yoga in Vedic birth chart, which is nothing but Sage Parashara says this. This Raja Yoga is very important because it brings a lot of name, fame, highly respectable. This person will be highly respectable in the society. But this combination is not good for the materialistic gains. But he will be gaining a lot of name, fame, popularity, reputation, and everything. First, let's talk about what is Ketu. Ketu is all about detachment. Ketu is all about, you know, nothingness, and whereas Sun is all about confidence, soul, and everything. When these two planets comes in conjunct with each other, then the Kirti Yoga will be formed in the Vedic birth chart. So this will be really good combination for someone getting into the respectable position. But this combination doesn't give you much of the materialistic gains, but it's really good for the undergoing the research abilities for the native to prosper. Okay, I can see a couple of guys join. Hi Gautam, hi Shuffle. And especially the Sun and Ketu should be 8 degrees apart in the Vedic birth chart. Then we can consider one of the Raja Yoga is formed here. And as I mentioned to you, this yoga provides a lot of research abilities to the native. And also, this yoga is good for the medical profession. This yoga is really good for the people who want to practice into the medical profession, because Ketu is all about investigation and all that. So Ketu is all about spirituality, investigation, okay? And the Sun is all about providing the career. So these people get a medical profession will be literally suitable for this person. The people who are into surgeons, you know, cardiology, cosmetologist, and also neurosurgeons, urologists, all these people emerge from this placement as well. They have very strong Ketu in the horoscope. Then only they can get into the medical profession. And also this combination is good for someone who want to practice law, who want to become a lawyer or judge. Okay. And also because this placement is all about providing, serving to the people. So a great politician also emerged from this placement. The great politician also emerged from this placement. And but most importantly, these people will be involved in terms of serving a lot of people. Like for example, people who want to set up NGOs, people are to running the charity homes, all emerge from this placement as well. Because Sun plus Ketu combination takes their journey to do all this stuff. Okay, because Sun represents soul, whereas Ketu represents spirituality, Ketu represents enlightenment. So this combination is also good for the people who want to become a yoga teacher, spiritual healers, spiritual teachers, okay, who can be a great scholar, Vedic scholar and all that. So, and also this combination also provides extreme heights in their career as well. Okay, this combination provides extreme heights in the career. And also, as I mentioned to you like earlier, like I'm just reading the notes which I have written for my analysis. So this combination is really really good for the people who want to serve the society, like setting up an NGO, setting up a charity, setting up a spiritual organization, and also hotel management, hospitality management is also good for this position. And but only drawback for this conjunction is this combination doesn't give you a lot of materialistic gains. Like in terms of wealth generation, there will be a little bit of struggle. But name, fame will be there for this person, because this yoga is a Kirti Yoga. And especially the people who want to progress spiritually, also this combination is really good. Okay. Especially Sun plus Ketu combination in the 7th house gives a lot of misunderstandings and conflicts with the spouse. And whereas Sun plus Ketu combination in the 8th house brings up a lot of obstacles in their journey, in their career, in their profession or whatsoever it matters. And also Sun plus Ketu combination doesn't work well in 2nd house and 11th house as well. Because 2nd house and 11th house talks about materialistic gains. So this combination doesn't work well. And the 4th house, Sun, if at all Sun and Ketu combination is there in your 1st house, this this combination is really good. This brings up the Raj Yoga for the person who have a great courage, who is known for his courage, bravery, and also this person will be highly respected in the society, because this yoga is formed as a Kirti Yoga. So this person is highly respected, and name and fame will be there for their efforts and all that. But in terms of generating the wealth, this is not a good position, good placement, I can say. Okay, and let's say if Sun and Ketu combination is there in your third house, this is good for the just for getting the courage and all that, because third house talks about courage, bravery and all that. But this placement gives some kind of misunderstandings with their younger siblings as well, because Ketu is the planet of quarrels and all that as well. So this gives a lot of planet of obstacles. So this gives the little bit of misunderstandings with the younger siblings. And let's say if Sun and Ketu combination is there in the fourth house, so this person can generate the wealth, but that wealth will not be used for his growth. It will be used for his family growth. His family will be enjoying those materialistic gains. This person will not have so much of attachment with that wealth which he generated. And let's say if Sun and Ketu combination is there in the fifth house, so this combination is really good for people who want to be, for the people who want to excel in their education, good for the academics, because fifth house talks about academics, education and all that. This person excel well in the academics. And the Sun and Ketu combination is there in the sixth house. This combination is really good for clearing off your debts, winning over your enemies, competition and everything. And about seventh and eighth house, I already spoke about you about that. And let's say Sun and Ketu combination is there in the ninth house of your Vedic birth chart. So this will brings up a lot of ancestral blessings. Ancestral blessings is really required for you to get awards and rewards in your life, to have a carefree life, actually, to have a very good, smoother life in your endeavors. And this brings up a lot of luck, undoubtedly, because ninth house talks about fortune. And also Sun plus Ketu combination in the ninth house brings up the foreign opportunities as well. Okay. And Sun plus Ketu combination in the 10th house brings up a solid profession. And this person gets into a very good position at a very early age, maybe by the age of 26 or 27. He will be attaining the career stability. He will be getting to the very good ports with at a very quicker pace. And his efforts will be awarded and rewarded for his hard work and everything. His hard work will be recognized. Okay. And 11th house, I already spoke to you. It's not good for the materialistic gains. So the 12th house is really good for the people who want to excel spiritually. And it's also good for getting the moksha. This person will attain the moksha in this life itself. Okay, so the people who have Sun and Ketu combination in the 2nd house, 11th house, 7th house, 8th house, as well as 3rd house, these people has to do the remedy for both Sun as well as to Ketu. Okay, these people has to do the remedy for both the Sun as well as Ketu. If at all, people having the Sun and Ketu combination in the 7th and 8th house, these people has to do the remedy before their marriage itself. These people has to do the remedy before the marriage itself. Because 7th house talks about marriage and spouse related matters, the partnership, the legal partnership, business partnership, okay? And Sun and Ketu combination is not good for even for the business dealings as well, because 3rd house talks about business, 7th and 8th talks about business, as well as 11th house for the finances, financial flow and all that. So this combination is not good. This combination is helps you to get your to get the name, fame, reputation and everything. This person will be courageous in terms of winning over the enemies, competition, clearing off the debts and everything. But in terms of materialistic progress, this combination is really not good. So these people has to do the remedy for both Sun and Ketu. Okay. So this is my analysis on Sun plus Ketu conjunction, which is considered as a Kirti Yoga. To summarize the whole content, Sun and Ketu combination in the 1st house, 4th house, 5th house, 6th house, 9th house, 10th house, 12th house is really good for you to gain very good name, fame, reputation in your endeavors, and also good for spirituality, spiritual progress, getting the ancestral blessings and getting into the foreign opportunities, getting into a desired profession. This combination really works in these houses which I mentioned. If Sun and Ketu combination is there in the 3rd house, it will be problem with the siblings, okay, secret enemies and all that. And if Sun and Ketu combination in the 7th and 8th house, and there will be issues with your spouse. There will be misunderstandings, conflicts, you know, exchange of the words and all that. Some people even might get into a separation as well. Okay. Sun and Ketu. Because Ketu is all about detachment. Okay. Ketu is all about detachment, nothingness. Okay. Only good thing about Ketu is he has the ability to think beyond. He has ability to think out of the box. He can think beyond. This person becomes a great writer, great orator, great communicator. Okay? Because Ketu is all about spirituality. But in terms of relationships and all, Ketu is not a good planet because Ketu is a planet of detachment. Okay? And yeah, 9th house, 10th house, I already spoke about you. It's very good for the foreign opportunities, getting, you know, getting very good desired career stability and all that. And 11th and 12th, 2nd house is not good because Ketu is all about detachment, detachment from the wealth as well. 2nd house and 11th house talks about the wealth. When Ketu is situating there, this person have to struggle a lot to get the materialistic gains. Okay. So that's it from my side. This is a short analysis on Sun and Ketu combination. So if you have any questions, you guys can put it in the comment box. So I'm really love to answer. If you need my one-on-one consultations, you guys can book at the link which is mentioned in the announcement section. Okay. Thank you so much for watching this video and bye for now. Tomorrow we'll come up with another Raja Yoga. Okay. Bye.